Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Clinical Biochemistry by Dr. P.K. Prabhakar. Today we are going to talk about Chargaff Rule. This Chargaff Rule, first before going to this discussing about Chargaff Rule, we should know something about DNA. Our DNA is a double helical structure where these two structures will be held together by hydrogen bonds. These hydrogen bonds is going to form between nucleotides. We are having two types of nucleotides, that is purine and pyrimidine. Purines we are having two types, that is adenine and guanine. Similarly, pyrimidine we are having thymine and cytosine. As we know that adenine forms two hydrogen bonds with thymine and guanine forms three hydrogen bonds with cytosine. So this is just a basic information about the how DNA is held together there. On DNA helix, if we are having adenine on one strand, on the complementary strands we have thymine. If we are having thymine on one strand, here we will have adenine. If we are having cytosine here, this side we will have guanine, or if we are having guanine here, this side we will have cytosine. So there will be two hydrogen bonds between adenine and thymine, and three hydrogen bonds between cytosine and guanine. Now we are coming towards Chargaff Rule. This Chargaff Rule was first proposed by Erwin Chargaff in the year of June 1949, and this was first published in May 1950. The most important thing of this rule is only applicable for double-stranded DNA. This is not applicable for RNA and single-stranded DNA. Now, according to the Chargaff Rule, Chargaff had proposed that the concentration of adenine will be equal to the concentration of thymine in a double-stranded DNA. Similarly, the concentration of guanine will be equal to concentration of cytosine. Now, if you add this two, so the concentration of adenine plus the concentration of guanine equal to the concentration of thymine plus the concentration of cytosine. And as we know, this is a purine. So the concentration of purine is equal to the concentration of pyrimidine in any double-stranded DNA. Now, if we write it, the concentration of adenine plus the concentration of thymine plus the concentration of cytosine plus the concentration of guanine in any cells where double-stranded DNA is there, it will be equal to, it makes the 100% of the nucleic acid. So it is 100%. Now we are going to see some of the numericals on this one. So we have to remember few things, that the concentration of adenine is equal to concentration of guanine, and the concentration of thymine, the concentration of guanine is equal to concentration of cytosine. Now there are few numericals we will say it. The first numerical we are going to say it, that in an organism, it is having 20% thymine. So we have to find out how much percentage of guanine is there. So that we have to find it. So the thing is, we know that the concentration of thymine is equal to concentration of adenine, and that is equal to 20%, which is given here. If we have now, we know that adenine plus thymine plus cytosine plus guanine equal to 100%. So 20% plus 20% plus C plus G equal to 100%, or the concentration of C plus concentration of G equal to 100% minus 40%. These two 20% will go that side and it will be minus. So it will be 60%. As we know, C is equal to G and G is equal to C. So both will be in equal concentration. So the concentration of C or the concentration of G is equal to 30% in each. Then now we are going to see another problem where the DNA is having the 120 number of adenine in the DNA is 120, and it is having cytosine also 120. So we have to find out the total number of nucleotides as well as the percentage of each nucleotide. As we know that adenine is equal to thymine, so 120, adenine is 120, thymine will be 120. Similarly, the concentration of cytosine equal to concentration of guanine. So this is 120, so guanine will be 120. Now total nucleotides equal to A plus T plus C plus G equal to 120 plus 120 plus 120 plus 120, that is 480, and all the nucleotides is going to make 100%, and every nucleotide is having equal contribution. So each nucleotide's contribution is 25%. Third problem we are going to see, where the given is the percentage of adenine is 40% and the percentage of thymine is 60%. What is our interpretation? How you are going to interpret it? So first we'll see, as we are knowing that according to this Chargaff rule, adenine should be equal to thymine. In this case, the adenine is not equal to thymine. Means, according to this formula, this is not going to follow this Chargaff rule. So certainly, and Chargaff rule, we are knowing that it is applicable only for double-stranded DNA. Here, this rule is not followed. It means this nucleotides where it is present is certainly not a double-stranded DNA. It will be single-stranded RNA. It is not RNA as thymine is given there, because in RNA we don't have uracil. So this is certainly a DNA, not RNA, and this is single-stranded DNA. Hope you have understood all these things. If you are having any problem, you can write comments. If you like this video, please share, subscribe and like it. Thank you.